On the next Roseanne show, Roseanne sits down with living legend Loretta Lynn to talk about life, love, and the other woman.
'Cause you ain't woman enough to take my man.
Then, from Sabrina the Teenage Witch, comic actress Caroline Ray.
I can relate to some of this dysfunctional dating stuff, but no, you're just like,
you know, the truth is I've never had a date. How sad is that? I've never had a date.
But I'm, really?
I just marry people.
There you go.
Yeah.
Today on The Roseanne Show, country legend superstar Loretta Lynn is here. And from the hit TV show, Sabrina the Teenage Witch, the hilarious Caroline Ray. And now, here I come.
What?
Oh, thank you. Thank you. How sweet. Well, I love you, too. We have such a great show today. And to start it off, we want to go right to the audience and ask you your opinions. Like, do you think Monica Lewinsky is going to accept the $2 million offer I made her? Do you have anything to say? What's Letterman offering her? Oh, he's doing it too?
Mm-hmm.
He's offered her $5 million, really? See,
yeah,
I never
because
watched.
He was worried that, what was the lady on Channel 7? Oprah?
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, he was worried about her.
He
was worried about Oprah getting her on his show, on her show.
Yeah.
But then she said, no, she's not going to have him, so that means David gets to have her. Unless you're going to have her, then he's going to be mad at you or something like that for having her here. He's trying to get her on his show. That's all it comes down to. And he's getting $5 million.
Okay, anybody else have any Monica Lewinsky statements or questions? Yeah, sir.
Who do you think is wrong, Linda Tripp, for coaching Monica to do this or Monica for actually doing it?
Oh, I think they're all messed up, every one of them. Don't you? There's no heroes in it. They're all crazy. Yes, sir.
I'm just wondering why she didn't stand by her man.
Who?
Monica Lewinsky.
She did, and that's how she got the stain. Okay. Yeah.
Honestly, I think she should leave Clinton alone and get a life, because she's just the past, period.
You think she'd call up here to get $2 million? Would you ever walk away from $2 million?
Well, I'd probably go for more.
Maybe we need to up that money. That's a good thought. Like, $2 million isn't enough?
No.
Okay. Any more? Yes, sir.
Ask a question.
Not you.
I was wondering why any woman would keep a dress that was stained if she wasn't planning on doing something in the first place.
Yeah, I wondered about that too. It's like, especially in Give It to Your Mom, it's kind of weird. Like, here, Mom, put this right next to my prom corsage. Yeah.
Are you afraid that the critics are going to think that she's profiting from the money she'll get from the interview?
Am I afraid that the critics are going to think that she's profiting from the money she'll get from the interview? What do I give a damn what they think? I'm trying to help the woman out, because I think, you know, she's not going to be able to ever have a job again. She better take this money while she can, is the way I look at it. She's going to need to move to a desert island, trust me. I've been famous 15 years, that's how it is.
I really think people ought to get on with their lives, and we should go ahead and take care of this country and stuff. There are too many homeless people and everything like that. I should get on with straightening out the
country. Well, I'll tell you what, if Monica don't come after that money, I'll give that money to the homeless people. Yeah, I don't know if that'll help my ratings, though. We'll be right back with Loretta Lynn after this. A musical icon and a living legend. I'm so happy she's here. Please help me welcome Loretta Lynn.
Thank
Do you think we learn anything from Mrs. Madison?
I don't know. What do you think?
Well, she's been married 8 times, huh?
Yeah, you've only been married 1 time.
Well, that's enough. This is what I'm wondering.
I'm on my 3rd, you know. But you managed to stay married for almost 50 years.
Yeah, it would have been 50 this year.
Oh. You just lost your husband. 50 years, and you're so young, and that's because you were 13 years old when you got married.
Right. Yeah. I kind of walked out of Daddy's arms into his arms. And, you know, I was the baby girl for... I think I was 9 when... Or maybe 10 when my sister come along. And, of course, I was always in Daddy's lap because I was jealous if he picked up one of the babies. So I'd get over in Daddy's lap and he'd have to rock me, too. So he was rocking me when I got married. So,
wow.
And then that...
It's not really that unusual to get married when you're 13.
No, it really is. From. You know, all the girls that I grew up with, cousins, and like I say, Kentucky looks like a telephone pole. Should I have said that?
That's all right.
It's okay.
They
know
to
it too, don't they?
Yeah, they know it.
But anyway.
I want to ask you something about that, though.
All right.
Can I ask you something?
Sure.
Because I was thinking, well, Loretta Lynn was 13 years old when she got married. And what do you think of this woman, Mary Kay Letourneau? They're giving her, you know, she's in all this trouble because she's in love with this student of hers who was 14 years old when she got with him. What do you think of that?
You know, I really never thought too much about it because you kind of try to stay out of something that you don't care about.
All right, so you don't
didn't bother me any, so
you don't think it's like so shocking because
well, it was. I wouldn't do it, but maybe it was okay for her. I mean, how can we be a judge?
Right.
You know, we can't judge.
Right. Well, because and you also had like 4 kids by the time you were 17 years old, didn't you?
Yes, and by the time I was 21, I had lost 3. You know, like I have Rh negative blood, but I didn't know it then, and no doctor told me. And I guess they didn't get paid. That's probably why they didn't tell me. But anyway, I lost 3 babies when it was 3 months or 4 months, and then found out when my sissy was born, she had her earlobe off, and they got to looking around. And then they told me, "You have Rh negative blood, and you may never have another baby." But after I went to Nashville, after I started singing, I thought, this is going to be very hard, which it was hard, very hard. I got pregnant after 2 or 3 years after I left and went to Nashville. And I worked right up till the babies was born, though. I worked up 1 night before the babies were born.
Wow. How old were you the first time you ever went on stage?
27.
Before you were on stage?
Uh-huh.
I thought you were, like, on stage when you were 14 or 15.
No, I was in the swing, rocking the swinging babies and mommies and rocking my babies. That's the only place my husband ever heard me sing. And it would be White Christmas or something like that, you know.
So you were 27 when you got the idea to go?
I didn't get the idea. It was his. He says, you, here's what we're going to do. I'm going to get you a job.
So you were just home with all these kids,
yeah.
And your husband had heard you sing, and he comes home one day, he's like, here's what we're going to do.
He got one of these little harmony guitars, which was like $17, I think, and I always wanted a wedding band, and it's broke right now, and it just about kills me, but I'm going to get it fixed. They tried to sell me a new one the other day when I took that in to get it fixed, and I said, I don't want your new one.
Of course you don't want
I don't want a new one. I want mine. And so, well, I kissed her. And I wanted to get it off my face.
I want to leave it there.
And,
No, I just can't believe that your husband comes home and goes, okay, Loretta, you're going to go start singing.
He did. He said, now you learn to play that. So I learned to play that. And I learned to play.
Well, did you think that was a crazy idea, or were you excited about
it,
or what?
Oh, I like to die. He pushed me on stage. I don't know how many times he pushed me out there. And I'd go on just scared to death, and then I'd leave the stage with a migraine headache. And I'd get over the headache around Wednesday and then start taking it again on Friday because I knew I was going to sing Saturday.
Were you making money that made you want to go?
$5 on a Saturday night.
It's like that old song, got $5 and it's Saturday night.
Well, how come you didn't say no to him?
Well,
you must have wanted to do
are
it.
Are you kidding me?
You
say no to him?
No. You couldn't say no to your husband?
Not too well.
Wow, so he's
let's put it like this. I had the 4 kids, and if one of them made a mistake or I made a mistake, then the little boogers would get into things during the day, and I couldn't whip them. I couldn't whip them to save my life. And I'd say, as soon as your daddy comes home, he'll kill you. And I'm going to tell him. And before, it didn't take but a couple of times that I quit that. Because when he come home, he whipped them, he give me one too.
So you went on stage to sing because you thought he was going to kick your butt if you didn't.
Well, I knew that he wasn't going to like it, and I knew we wouldn't get along, so I knew that things wouldn't go very well.
Man. He said,
2 years, and we'll have enough money to buy us a home.
Okay.
Well,
so you thought
years,
there was going to be an end? Because you didn't ever like it?
Well, no, because I had never done it. You got to realize, where I come from, Roseanne, was way in the back in the mountains. Mm-hmm. And then when he brought me to Washington State, I never got out of the house. One time I went to the grocery store in 1 year and was scared to death to go in. He'd usually pick up a few groceries on the way home from work. And
I can't even deal with that. It's so amazing.
It's true.
It's so amazing.
So when I started...
And then, like, these songs. When did you start writing songs? Let's talk about that. Because the songs you wrote were about this really strong woman who was, like, so defiant.
And about this ornery man.
Oh, well, let's take a commercial and come back and talk about that.
Okay.
Don't go anywhere. More with Loretta Lynn after these messages. Transform country music. Nobody had ever heard anything like the songs you wrote before.
That's right.
Because there was a lot of kind of women victim songs about, oh, my husband left me and he kicked my butt and he whatever, you know. You know how country. But your songs were different because, let's talk about the kind of songs you wrote.
Well, the songs that they were singing were, Little Darling, I'll Be Here When You Come Home. And I'm not that kind of person. I might have been little, but I fought. He never hit me once, and I didn't hit him twice. Let's put it that way. I did, and I wasn't very big. 5'2" ain't too big, and I always said I was 5'3", and he'd say, Loretta, why do you lie like that? I wanted to be taller than 5'2", so I made myself 5'3", but...
But your song's, like, totally shocked.
Yeah, you know, they banned a lot of them, and the band The Pill, and I'm the only one who never took it. Every woman I knew
took
The Pill. Because I'd get down from a club, you know, when I work in clubs, I'd do 4 shows a night, and then I'd take a 10-minute break every hour. I'd get down, talk to the people in the club, and all the women were taking the pill. So I never thought
about birth control pills. You know. Because, like, in our time, these people are young. I don't even know if they know that. That was a big deal when women got birth control pills.
Yeah.
Say one or two of the lines in that song.
But the thing of it was, if I'd had them, I'd eat them like popcorn. Because let me tell you. They're, like The Pill? Let's see.
Say a couple lines of that song.
I'll start. Well, I can't even think
of stuff. Oh, well, okay, I'll say it. You're like, well, this and that and the other, but, you know, things are going to change because now I've got The Pill.
You set this chick in your last time because now I've got The Pill. Let's see, how does it start out? You wine me and dine me when I was your girl. Promised if I'd be your wife, you'd show me the world. All I've seen of this old world is a bed and a doctor bill. I'm tearing down your brooder house, cause now I've got The Pill.
That song and I Am Woman, Hear Me Roar, I mean, those were like groundbreaking songs for women to hear.
And, you know, when I went in writing Don't Come Home A-Drinkin'.
Oh, I love
Fist
that one.
City, and
Don't
I had a
Come
good
Home
reason.
A-Drinkin' with Lovin' on Your
That's
Mind.
That's right. And it's just as bad if you come home a-lovin' with drinking on your mind. Turn it around, Roseanne. But it's terrible.
And Fist City.
Yeah, Fist City, I wrote that about an old girl. That
Tell us that story.
Yeah, she was a school bus driver. And she'll probably see this show, and I hope she does.
Tell us about that.
I'd like to finish her off.
why is that, Loretta?
Well, I don't like her.
Why not?
Well, she told my little girl, Sissy, she said, when I walked in, Sissy says, Mama, the girl bus driver is going to take Daddy away from us. She says that her and Daddy are in love. I said, is that right? She said, yes. And she was crying and all this, so I jumped due as he walked in the door. I said, so you're going with the bus driver? And he took off in a hurry, and I wondered where he went. But he went down to the little roadside tavern and called her.
Oh.
Yeah, he didn't come in the house and called her. He went down there and called her. Told her to come over and tell a lie. I said, tell her there's nothing going on. Well, she had my horse in her pasture. Don't tell me there wasn't something going on. She had a whole bunch of little kids, you know. And her husband left her, and I know why. And I wonder if some woman now hadn't finished her off. I don't know.
You shouldn't mess with another woman's man. Shouldn't do
no,
that.
Not if they're getting along. Or if they ain't. I mean, men do. I wouldn't even get home to say hello till, you know, I'd hear this before you get in, you know.
You hear what?
These things were going on. Oh. So I wrote all these fighting songs. And I just bought the little town of Hurricane Mills when this happened. And so I said, you better detour around my town. She detoured, too.
You say, if you don't want to sing a little bit of that one.
Well, for crying out loud.
Well, you... How does it go? I know all the words. You've been making your brags around
That's
town.
That's right. Well, you don't know my song better than me.
No, I know all your songs.
You've been making your brags around town that you've been a loving my man. But the man I love, when he picks up trash, he puts it in a garbage can. That's what she looked like, too. That's what you look like to me.
Keep going. I want to hear.
What I see is a pity. You better close your face and stay out of my way if you don't want to go to Fish City.
Yeah.
I got it too high for the
course. We'll be back. Stay tuned.
The chorus went there.
Relief.
Have you heard what critics are saying about The Roseanne Show? Time magazine says Roseanne can be appealingly authentic.
Hello!
The New York Times writes, surprisingly smart and winning, a mix of sharp topical conversation, occasional comedy sketches, and social work without sentimentality.
All right!
Entertainment Weekly says Roseanne remains endlessly fascinating. It's fun to watch her. See what all the buzz is about on The Roseanne Show.
Oh, wonderful. Thank you. Performing Coal Miner's Daughter, a song that she has not performed with her guitar for 28 years, and that she wrote, and thank God you're writing music again. I can't wait to hear the new stuff. Miss Loretta Lynn.
So if I miss a chord out there, I just don't think nothing of it. Do just like me, keep going. Well, I was born the coal miner's daughter in a cabin on a hill in Butcher Holler. We were poor, but we had love. That's the one thing that Daddy made sure of. He shoveled coal to make a poor man's dollar. My daddy worked all night in the Van Leer coal mines, all day long in the fields of hoeing corn. Mommy rocked the babies at night and read the Bible by the coal oil light, and everything would start all over come break of morn. Daddy loved and raised eight kids on pay. Mommy scrubbed our clothes on a washboard every day. Well, I've seen her fingers bleed to complain there was no need. Shit small in Mommy's understanding way. I remember well the well where I drew water.
we were torn. I never thought of ever leaving, but your heart. Well, a lot of things have changed since way back then. Oh, and it's so good to be back home again.
Come on.
Not much left but the floors. Nothing lives here anymore. Except the memories of a coal miner's daughter.
We love you. We love you.
I love you too.
Thank you, Loretta.
Thank you,
so
honey.
Beautiful. Thank you very much. You come back.
And want to see my show, call 1-800-485-6885.
We'll talk about you being a single woman now. Do you want to talk about
okay.
That?
Okay.
I just had this feeling, and I wanted to say to you, and I did say it to you, but I want to say it to you in front of everybody.
Okay.
I think Loretta Lynn is just starting a whole new thing. I think you are just starting out on a whole new thing that you've never been able to do before.
Roseanne, you know, I've often thought this myself, you know, that I never have done what I have really meant to do, what God has really meant for me to do. Let's put it that way.
But now
and
you feel
I
like
think
you...
That, I think that I will be doing everything that he's put me here for. And I think I want to tell you something, honey. I love you so much. This is a brand new guitar. Epiphone guitar, and I've wrote three new songs on the way out here.
You did?
Yes, I did. On this guitar, and I'm gonna give you this guitar.
Wow.
In that case.
You know, I don't even know how to play it or anything.
Thank you.
Will you sign it for me?
Oh, you don't want that.
Huh? Will you sign it for me?
No, I want you to learn to play it so we can do a show together.
Oh, cool.
Look at here, that's
an
A.
All right.
As long as you got no A, D, and E, and you can write any song or sing any song. Or you can start in D, G, and A. Just get your guitar book.
Okay, next time for when you come back, I'll know how to do that. I gotta have a week or two to learn.
Well, yeah, it takes a little time, but I wanted you to have that.
That is so sweet of you, thank you.
Well,
that
you're
means so much to me, thank you.
Now we're a duo.
I want to sing with you. Are you going to sing with me? Can we sing a song together?
Yes.
I just want to sing with you because you're like the only person that I can sing with. You know why? Because Loretta Lynn, I have to say this, when our President George Bush got mad at me for singing the national anthem and singing it real bad.
Well, it wasn't her fault.
He said I was disgusting. His good friend... He said I was a disgrace. Loretta Lynn is his good friend, and she went to the president and stuck up for me to him, didn't you?
That's right.
And,
and
I thank you for that.
Well, I want everybody to know why you did this, too. She did this because these people kept wanting her to come down and do this. She did what they told her to do, and she knew nothing about what was going on. And that made
or
me
singing.
Mad, too. And George had to go out and do something, or they were hollering at him. So I wanted to straighten that out.
Well, thank you.
Okay, we're gonna say you ain't woman enough to take my man.
Yeah.
So don't wanna have you try.
Check out these words.
You've come to tell me something. You say I ought to know that he don't love me anymore, and I'll have to let him go. You say you're gonna take him. Oh, but I don't think you can. 'Cause you ain't woman enough to take my man. Yeah. Women like you, they're a dime a dozen. You can buy them
anywhere.
For you to get to him, I have to move over and I'm gonna stand right here. It'll be over my dead body, so get out while you can. 'Cause you ain't woman enough.
Hey, you did real great.
Thank you for letting me sit with you.
Nothing.
I'm going to practice
that. All we need is a little practice. See, that was D-G. That was A.
A, D, and D-N-G. Now, I'm going to practice that for okay, next
that's
time
right.
you
just
come back.
Just bring it right down there, your finger.
All right.
Right in there. Just get this, hold that one.
Wow.
This one right here, too.
Huh?
Can you put your finger out over there?
What's finger?
That'll be A.
Like that?
No. Just one finger.
I need to get
there
me
you
a lesson
go. You
or
got
chair
it.
There,
you
Loretta.
Got that? There's A.
All right.
Just hold all them frets down, that's A.
Okay.
Now that's, now I'll go to G. You can do this for G in this
one. I know this one, Loretta.
Catch, is that G? That's G.
That's the only one I do know.
Okay, that's half of the battle right there. Now, D. That's the only one you don't know. The A is just, you know, just the second
well,
fret.
I'm gonna forget A.
Just put this right there.
All right.
This here.
All right.
Now this one right there.
But,
mm-mm.
I'm getting a cramp, Loretta.
Now there's your D.
Getting a cramp in the finger there.
You learn them three. Yes. You already know G. And A is right here. You'll get it because you can.
I will practice and practice till you come back because I want to be your partner.
Okay.
Thank you.
We will do a duet.
Give me a big old kiss.
I love you.
Thank you. I love you.
Thank you for being on my show.
Hey.
Thank you for that weird guitar.
On the next Roseanne Show, it's all about sex with former Baywatch babe Tracy Bingham.
Tonight, get the great taste of the grill with Gorton's Grilled Filets, sizzling with flavors like lemon pepper or garlic butter.
Dress the Gorton's Fisherman.
Is a hilarious comedian who plays the spellcasting Aunt Hilda on Sabrina the Teenage Witch. Please welcome Caroline Ray. Thank you. You're really funny. You're very funny. I've seen your stand-up, too. I thought I was going to be able to meet you before.
Oh, really? I've seen you. Good. You look fantastic.
Why, thank you, my
dear.
And
I love your new do. I love your hairdo.
It takes, like, hours and hours, but anyway. here's this good question I have. How come a fat guy like Drew Carey gets to have a really hot girlfriend like you on his show?
Gee, how do I answer that politically correctly? You know what? When I was, I played Drew's girlfriend for a couple of episodes, and then it turned out that I was married. Hoe than I am. And to Eric Roberts, that was a big shocker.
Wow.
Yeah, I know. But he wouldn't kiss me during any of the rehearsals.
Who, Drew?
Yeah.
Why?
He was like, we'll do it on the day, we'll do it on the day. I was like,
I was like that. I could not ever
you
kiss
couldn't...
him. No. Me and John Goodman both on the Roseanne Show, we were both so freaked out that we'd ever have to kiss. Because, you know, we were such good friends and it just didn't go. So, like, we would go on this, like, psychic building thing where we'd walk around the parking lot arm in arm for about 20 minutes going, we can do it, we can do it. And then we'd try really hard not to, like, just start laughing or sweating and stuff like that. It's hard to kiss somebody.
Well, the day of the taping, Drew rammed his tongue so far down my throat, I thought I was going to have a heart attack. I was like, oh, I know, ew. And, no, it was fun. Lots of
Ooh, that's nasty.
No, it's just sort of my shocked expression, like, oh,
honey.
Oh,
that's why he said, save it for the day.
Save it for the day.
Now you're like a big witch.
Yeah, I'm a big witch.
On TV. Do you believe in witchcraft?
Absolutely. You were a really good witch, though, in New York.
I was a good bad witch.
You were a very good bad witch.
Did you
see
me?
It's weird being a good... No, I couldn't get tickets
to
see you.
Well, then don't tell me that I was good if you didn't say it.
I saw excerpts of you in which you appeared excellent. okay.
Fun playing the Wicked Witch.
Oh, you
that
did?
Was the most fun I've ever had.
I saw the excerpt of you flying through the air, and I thought you did that really well.
It was just so cool. I'm going to do that on Halloween on this show. I'm going to
be
her again because it's so awesome. I love witches and stuff. And the
did
whole
people
mythology.
Say stupid things to you though when you were a witch? Like ask you to, you know? Every time I'm in line at the airport, and someone goes, "Why can't you make the line disappear?"
No.
Like, well, if I could make anything disappear, it would be you.
People, like, mistake you for, like, a real witch all the time, don't they?
When, after the show came on, it had been on for about 2 weeks, and I was walking through Bloomingdale's, and I heard this mother say to her little daughter, "No, darling, that woman does not look like a witch, and that's not very polite." I was like, but I am a witch.
How cool is it? I like that story where you're on the plane with Sigourney Weaver.
Oh, that was really cool.
Tell us that story. It's so cool.
I was sitting on the plane, and Sigourney Weaver sat down next to me, and I was, like, completely terrified because she's quite an amazing presence. She's just sort of...
And she's a great, great actor.
She's an amazing actress, and she's, like, bone thin and so beautiful and sitting next to me, and literally the stewardesses are like this to me, you know, so that they can get to Sigourney Weaver, and I'm, like, nervous. And, So I call my sister, because I'm sitting next to Sigourney Weaver, so I call my sister, and we're from Canada, and I go, oh, I hear it's really cold in Montreal right now. And she goes, yeah, there's a big ice storm. And I go, yeah, exactly. And she goes, you're sitting next to Sigourney Weaver. I'm like, good guess. Just from the ice storm movie. That was pretty good. Huh?
Really?
Yeah. So, of course.
So your sister's a big witch, too.
Yeah. So, of course, Sigourney Weaver knew. It's just like, oh, hi. And then, you know. And then I said, in my insecure little voice, I go, you know, I'm an actress too, like this, like this little peon. And she goes, oh, really? What show are you on? And I go, I'm on Sabrina the Teenage Witch. And she goes, oh, that's my daughter's favorite show. Can I have your autograph? And I'm like, wow. Well, I don't know about that. Maybe.
But didn't she, like, commit to coming on
the
show?
Yeah, I think she is. She's going to come
so
on.
Isn't that so cool?
Isn't that cool? She's going to be a good witch. You should come and be a witch on Sabrina.
Oh, I should, shouldn't I?
You should. You definitely should.
Oh, I should.
It's much better.
I like to be the mean one. I love being the mean witch. It's so much cooler than the nice wimpy witch.
Well, we're kind of nice.
And do you like go to psychics and astrologers and all that kind of stuff too,
completely.
Right?
Oh, completely. What are you?
I totally get into all that.
Are you
that.
A Scorpio? No.
Yeah.
What are you? You are a Scorpio?
Yeah. What are you?
I don't know. You're a Scorpio. How freaky. I've probably read it 8 million times. I'm an Aries.
What month is Aries?
A much more popular month than Scorpio, clearly.
What month is Aries?
April.
I don't know if I know any Aries.
April.
Oh. So tell us about the psychics. You believe stuff? Somebody told you were going to be working for 7 years, a psychic?
No, the psychic said whatever show you start now will be on the air for 7 years. Isn't that weird? But the same psychic also told me this, you know, like they're channeling dead people, right?
Right.
And then they said, you will also lose those 15 pounds. I'm like, someone in heaven is judging me? I can't believe this. They're like...
Really? She said that?
The chubby one is mine. You know, that's what I feel like they're saying. Yeah.
I really like all that stuff. I like
do
that
too.
Unspoken, intuitive kind of... Actually, it's like the...
You and I have a best friend in common, or a close friend.
Who's that?
Kevin O'Quinn, the makeup artist.
Oh, my God. How great is he?
He's the greatest. And I met him on an airplane, too.
You need to stay off airplanes. So... Tell us some more. Tell us about your dating experience.
I'm the best new boyfriend. I don't even know. I can't even stand. I'm finally ready to go out with a nice man.
As Why, long do you as have, I like, have, a whole bunch of jerks
yeah,
behind you?
Yeah, as long
you?
As I have, like, a really mean one on the side. That's what I You know, I can do that. No, you know, didn't you go through the one a rotten guy phase?
Don't all women? We all, like, we get the one psychopath before we get the nice guy, don't we?
I've had a few psychopaths, yeah.
Really? What did you work out karmically in your head so you could move on to a nice guy?
I don't know. I have no idea, but this one's so nice. It's disgusting.
Like, is it going to last, though, or is it going to, like, flip out in, like, a week or two?
No, I can't. I think it's going to look at me. I'm like a two-year-old. Ugh, it's revolting. I've become those couples that I'm repulsed by. Like baby talk, and it just makes me sick, and I'm them. It's horrible.
And it makes you sick? You should be glad that you have that.
I know.
All right.
Okay.
Stick around to find out what a first date is like with Miss Ray. Frightening, I imagine.
I've completely forgotten. Nothing more pathetic than a woman who clings to the past.
Unless it's one who sits around in a bathrobe and fuzzy slippers talking to her cat.
Comfy. Well, I'm glad to see you've made peace with my dating Willard. You have fun now. She's gone. Let's Taylor.
Change me back. No amount of tuna is worth this whole factory nightmare.
And I'd like to start with Caroline Ray.
Caroline Ray from Sabrina. Hi, Caroline. An American woman sued and won $1.2 million from McDonald's when something hot ended up in her lap. What was it?
A very lonely Ronald McDonald. McDonald.
You're a single woman, aren't you? You're single. Have you ever been married or anything?
I wasn't. Oh, my first husband was an actor, yeah. Well, he wasn't my husband, but he was a really good actor. No, I've never been married.
So are you dating anyone now?
Yes, I have the nicest boyfriend in the world.
Really?
Yeah. Is that a new thing, having a nice guy?
Yes. His name is Bob, and he's a Gemini. Yay, Gemini.
Gemini, so there's three of us. Aries?
And, yeah.
Gemini and Aries?
Yes, very, very compatible. Yeah.
Where'd you meet him?
We actually met doing comic relief.
So he's an actor but not a comic?
No, he works for, like, nonprofit organizations.
What was he doing at comic relief? What was he doing there? Uh-oh, I sense a story.
No, there's no story. You're just so funny, even the way you ask questions. He was working, like, helping the homeless.
Oh.
You know, that's the other part of comic relief, that it raises money
helping
for the homeless.
Helping the homeless?
Look at you.
How'd you cook up with him? You sure as hell weren't down there helping the homeless.
He's always saying things like, you know, what are you doing? Oh, well, I have to, you know, help the homeless and, you know, people.
So he's married too then?
Yeah. No.
No, the homeless is his other family.
Yeah, the homeless.
No.
No.
So, tell us about dating him.
He's very nice. On our first date, we went to the Denver Zoo.
In Denver?
Yeah.
You're from Denver too?
No, I'm not from Denver.
Oh, okay,
are
whatever.
Are you from Denver?
Well, I live there.
Is that where you're from though? Where are you from?
No, from Salt Lake City and then Denver.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm so easily distracted. I'd much rather hear about you than tell my story. Okay.
Tell the damn Denver Zoo story. Tell the story before I just start slapping you.
This is what I was afraid of. I was afraid of this.
And I'd start
and
slapping
look what
you.
What happened? And then she just dope slapped me right across the stage. Now, we were going to the zoo, and so we were walking along, and all of a sudden we saw these two camels, and one camel was like about, like he was standing over the other camel. The female camel was like this, like, like just this look of like dread on her face, right? Maybe I was reading into it. I don't know. And then the other camel, you know, the guy camel standing like right over her with this like expression on his face. So that one I recognized for sure. So I thought this is so embarrassing because members of the animal kingdom are like further along in their relationship than I am. We haven't even kissed and they're about to like, I go, oh my God, they're about to have sex. And he goes, no, he's just shading her. I'm like, oh yeah, right. I go, well, don't ever use that line on me, okay? I'm shading you, get away. But then I heard like camel sex is like, rah! Like the loudest noise you've ever heard.
So did you guys just stand there and watch
it? Yeah, it was great, we got it on video. No, we watch it every Friday. No,
That's kind of sweet that you'd be embarrassed on your first date.
Yes, well, I was embarrassed the first 2 months. You know what, we were kissing in the car the first date, and I didn't realize it, but my foot like was on the gas. So as we were kissing, I'm like vroom, vroom, vroom. And I was like, what is that noise? And it's me.
Well, were you parked?
This is much worse than a first date. You know?
What, being here? I know, isn't it? Like, it's kind of embarrassing to talk about all your private stuff, isn't it? Like on camera. Isn't it weird?
It is weird. But I was just saying that, you know, I wouldn't be here. None of these female comedians would be successful if Roseanne hadn't done what she does.
Oh,
you're a total pioneer.
You. Oh, thank you.
It's true.
Thank you very much.
It's absolutely true.
So I want to know, the car was on while you were making out in the car?
Yeah, I was totally a wimp. You know, like when you're attracted to someone, you just send them away and then he got out of the car and went to his car. And then I said, no, come back and get in the car.
Okay, now wait a minute. You're both in a, both in cars?
I thought you could relate to some of this dysfunctional dating stuff, but no, you're just like,
you know,
huh?
The truth is I've never had a date. How sad is that? I've never had a date.
But I've really?
I just marry people.
There you go.
Yeah.
You have the wedding date. That's good.
Yeah, I guess a wedding is a date. Yeah, that's right. You practice and you
anticipate.
That's like
a party and dinner and everything.
Yeah. Hey, tell us about,
What?
Tell us about Billy Baldwin, who you think is a real babe.
Do you think he's a babe?
Oh, I think all the Baldwins are babes. Are you kidding?
Oh, they're all babes.
The women think they're babes.
I was on an airplane.
Who do you think's the biggest babe of the whole Baldwin family?
Oh, Billy, for sure.
Oh, the biggest?
Absolutely.
You don't think Alan's a bigger babe than
Alan?
Billy?
Alec.
I mean, whatever.
I think Alan Thicke is a bigger babe, though.
No, not Alan Thicke. Oh,
okay.
No.
Okay, I was kidding.
I mean, Alec, I'm sorry.
Alec
Baldwin, it's babe. Alec, then Billy, then Stephen. Tell us about Stephen Baldwin.
I don't know about Stephen Baldwin.
Well, which one is it, Billy? Which one? Which one is in the cab with
it's
you?
It's kind of like being interrogated and interviewed. Tell us about Billy, okay? All right, I'm going to tell you about Billy Baldwin. That's all I know, Roseanne, I swear, okay? Like, you know, you cut, there's gun in the back of my head. Tell the camel story. Okay. No.
But what's the one you were in the cab with? Oh, did I blow that one too?
You were the first.
I blew that story too. I'm sad today. I'm just sad.
Like,
okay.
Who's there? Come on in. Knock, knock. That's who you're telling the jokes.
Well, you know, it's
Billy
hard.
Baldwin.
Oh, that's who you were
in a cab with.
Oh, okay.
No, Billy Baldwin sat next to me on an airplane once, about 10 years ago.
Okay.
Yeah, because I was about 18. And, never mind. Okay, so.
Okay.
So Billy Baldwin is sitting next to me, and he's very handsome.
Yeah.
Sorry, just checking if there's an earthquake or anything.
Yeah.
Seeing if my magic worked. so I could fall into the ground now. It's like the opposite of comedy. I'm laughing and they're just staring at me. I think this is going so well. Okay, so until she choked to death and died. Okay.
You're on a plane with...
Okay. Billy Baldwin.
Okay.
Anyway, we shared a cab on the way home because we lived near each other.
Yeah.
And I was so mesmerized by how gorgeous he was, I said bye, and then I left all my luggage in the cab. Oh, don't even laugh. It took 4 hours to tell. Please.
And then, but you didn't get it back either, did you?
No, I never got it back. No, it's just really a pathetic, sad story.
Because you were like hypnotized by the beauty of Billy Baldwin. Did I say it right? Billy Baldwin?
Stephen!
Oh.
No,
okay.
Anything else you want to know?
Let's see. You've told us about camels humping, losing your luggage. No, I think that's about it.
Okay, that's all I came
for. And Sigourney Weaver.
There you go.
Very cool.
We're all done. And you ruined my eyeliner. Thanks a lot. Appreciate it.
I would like to thank all my guests today, and thank you for watching, and, you know, thank you all for showing up. You're very fun.
Yum is back, opening our heart, even expanding our vocabulary. Iyanla's changing lives with laughter and joy. Next, Oprah.
Followed by News 8 at 5 here on Channel 8.